Hello, lip syncers. Miss Gloria Swansong here, and I am, for fun week, I'm going to show you my apartment, my new apartment in New York City, and I'm going to do a little bit of a lip sync for you. So, in case you're wondering about my outfit, this is what I wear every Sunday, you know, when I'm baking and laying around the house and just feeling at home glamour. So, to start the little tour of my room, here is my little desk area where all the painting and the magic and the sewing happens. Those are some drawings I've done of very attractive men. You'll see over here is a window, the first window of two. Bookshelf, bed with my quilt that I made, and all my hats that I've made. Another window with a bookshelf, and there's another tchotchke shelf up there with some photos of relatives and another painting of a very attractive man. And there's another portrait that I did of Miss Judy Conte. So, the other thing I'm going to show you today was a few of my favorite books from my book collection, because I'm quite the book fiend. And by the way, I don't think I gave you my full outfit here, but a at-home Sunday realness is not complete without the gingham apron. So one of my most favorite books is this book from the 1950s called Fashion is Spinach. It's a really delightful book by Elizabeth Howes, and it's basically, she basically reads all of the bitches in the 1950s for being unoriginal and mass consumerist, and she's kind of a feminist before feminism was a thing. Another one of my favorite books, my favorite cookbook, is my cookbook of Southern biscuits. I have my own biscuit recipe that was handed down to me from my grandmother, but this is an iteration of over 100 different kinds of Southern biscuits. It's really quite a spectacular book. And to go along with that, I wanted to show you something that's really special, and that is, these are actually the biscuit cutters that my great-grandmother used late in her life, and they are condensed milk cans. I just thought they were really fabulous, and I kept them. Of course, I don't cut my biscuits, I hand roll them now. And so now, I'm going to show you one of my favorite costume books, and this is Dressed a Century in Hollywood Costume Design. This is a fabulous book, if you don't own it already, and it has a wonderful section on me, of course, because I'm a style icon, and I'll show you the section that has me in my beautiful costume, designed by Miss Edith Head, in Sunset Boulevard. So for the next part of Fun Week, I'm going to do a lip sync for you from one of my favorite Southern TV shows called Designing Women, one of the best TV shows to ever grace the small screen. And I'm going to be doing a speech by the character named Julia Sugarbaker. In this episode, Julia Sugarbaker, her sister, Suzanne Sugarbaker, is a former pageant queen who has returned to the pageant circuit only to find that she's being criticized by the other queens behind her back. And Julia, in classic Southern woman fashion, tells it like it is. So, enjoy.
Excuse me. Aren't you Marjorie Lee Winnick, the current Miss Georgia World?
Why, yes, I am.
I'm Julia Sugarbaker, Suzanne Sugarbaker's sister. I couldn't help overhearing part of your conversation.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't know anyone was here.
Yes, and I gather from your comments there are a couple of other things you don't know, Marjorie. For example, you probably didn't know that Suzanne was the only contestant in Georgia pageant history to sweep every category except congeniality. And that is not something the women in my family aspire to anyway.
This really
or that when she walked down the runway in her swimsuit, five contestants quit on the spot. Or that when she emerged from the isolation booth to answer the question, what would you do to prevent war? She spoke so eloquently of patriotism, battlefields, and diamond tiaras, grown men wept.
That's really...
And you probably didn't know, Marjorie, that Suzanne was not just any Miss Georgia. She was the Miss Georgia. She didn't twirl just a baton. That baton was on fire.
Look, that's...
And when she threw that baton into the air, it flew higher, further, faster than any baton has ever flown before, hitting a transformer and showering the darkened arena with sparks.
Look.
And when it finally did come down, Marjorie, my sister caught that baton, and 12,000 people jumped to their feet for 16 and one half minutes of uninterrupted thunderous ovation as flames illuminated her tear-stained face. And that, Marjorie, just so you will know, and your children will someday know, is the night the lights went out in Georgia.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Well, now you do.